Everything. Question what the tea. Hi, everybody. Welcome in. How are you? Happy Tuesday. My goodness, I haven't streamed on Tuesdays in forever. I want to say I believe I used to have Mondays and Tuesdays as like regular days on my schedule. And then for the longest time, I didn't stream on Mondays or Tuesdays. I just once again have like a packed week in a way that I would have wanted to stream tomorrow instead of today. However, I have a really late doctor's appointment. Like I had to, when I went for my dermatologist appointment recently, I had forgotten to put my new insurance card in my wallet. And so they were not able to see me at that time, which was really irritating because I'd specifically requested like to have a half day at work because of it. It was a whole thing. But they were like, okay, he actually has an opening coming up on the 31st. And it's like, okay, fine. You know, whatever. I'll have to make it work. And they're like, it's at 6:20 at night. I went, what? Like, I genuinely was so confused. Because what? I mean, I guess it's not a full doctor. It's a dermatologist, you know, it's a specialist. But still, have you ever heard of a doctor's office still having an appointment? Not even still open till, but my appointment starts at. I mean, it's not a long appointment, but I'm like, what? Huh? I was so surprised. I was like, this works perfectly for me because, you know, we at the bank at work, we close at 5, you know, by the time we finish all the closing up and everything, we're leaving at the latest, like 5:30. So I'm like, okay. Then I just have to dart over to okay. Yeah. I mean, that works. I'll definitely be out of work by then. But I was like, oh, I definitely won't be able to stream because I wouldn't be able to start stream till like 7:30, and then I have work again the next day, and I'm like, better to just not schedule a stream for Wednesday. I wanted to, but I was like, feels like I'm playing, not with fire, but like, feels like it'd end up being like 2 hours in, I'd look down at what time, and I'd be like, I gotta go to work tomorrow. So that's why I'm streaming today on a Tuesday. I don't know. It's unusual. It's just as unusual for me as it is for you. But today we're going to be playing Cult of the Lamb, which I'm so, so excited for. I'm sure you've seen other people playing it. That's got nothing to do with me. But I have wanted to do this game. For the longest time, I was like, it's not of interest that much to me. And then I was watching somebody play it and I was just like, I'm hooked. Like, I'm so enthralled by this. And I was like, I have to play it because the chance to let all of you in the game, to do your chaos, to do your mischief, I couldn't miss that opportunity. So remember, you all will have the opportunity to join and become members of the cult. I hope to see a bunch of you in here. I should have come up with backup names of people I can put in. I'm sure I can. If I need extra people, I'll toss in Brady. I'll toss in Chase. And then you're going to kill us and eat us. Mods. Can we? I don't. Mods. No. I would never. Helios. I would literally never do. Look at me. Look at this face. Bella, does this look like the face of a killer?
Lana. Lana!
What?
Hi, DJ. Listen, if anyone wants to learn how to make a clap, I'm here. How dare you say that in my chat, this filth? Welcome to the States, Mischief. Lana, how are you? I'm a little scared to have Lana here. I don't know what Lana's gonna do if Lana makes it into the cult. It does look like the face of Wolverine. I know, I need to shave. I know. By stream on Saturday, I will have shaved. And I don't know, I don't want to hold myself to that. If I haven't shaved by Saturday, I will do what? What should I do as my punishment? Pitch ideas in chat and I'll either approve or disapprove. Where did I hear that before? I don't know what you're talking about. No shave February? No, I need to shave. I might be going out on Thursday. You know what's so, and I understand because it's not my decision, but so annoying is I'm supposed to be in for 8:30 on Friday, but I'm not closing. So I asked my boss, I was like, oh, can we? I was like, I'm sure it's fine, but just in case it's not, let me ask. I was like, can I push back my shift start time on Friday and just stay till close? It would have bought me like an hour and 15 minutes, mind you. I wouldn't have been in work until like almost 10. And he was like, no. And I was like, because I figured it's like such a non-issue. Like, of course I can. And he was like, no, I think I already have two people on for closing. And I was like, because it's usually so like, whatever, you know, whatever, whatever's fine. And this was like, no. And I was like, what? Why do you want to stay late on a Friday? I want to not have to be in till late on a Friday because I think I want to go out Thursday night. And then I'm talking to my coworker and he's like, well, why do you need to? And I was like, I don't know, because I kind of want to go out on Thursday. And I was like, if I'm out, that means I'm not getting home till like 3 maybe. And then to be in work 5 hours later, like, I don't know. I was like, I don't know. And who says that I'm even going to be starting my process in the morning from my house? You know, I said it's not out of a question. I may still be in Massachusetts at come the morning. So I was like, all right. I mean, we'll see. I would simply quit. Lana, I was shocked. I was like, as I literally, you know what I did today? I counted out my PTO. So my family is officially, we're going to Mexico in April. And then I'm taking 2 half days in May for Eurovision. And then I want my birthday off. So I literally had to go in today and count out the pay cycles of how much PTO I was going to get for each one to make sure that I was going to have enough. And it turns out a good slash bad sort of is through my birthday, I have exactly as much like I'm going to, for taking my birthday off, that 8 hours is going to cut me exactly down to zero. And I'm like, ooh. Now we get like, it's called flex time. We get it a batch amount at the start. We get 7 days at the start of the year. It's just a batch amount. But that's like our sick time. That's our whatever. So I'm like, I'll have that as absolute backup. But I'm like, I don't really want to go like dipping into that. You know what I mean? If I can avoid it, especially this soon in the year. So how many days off do you get per year? Right now? Oh God. There's 10 holidays, which currently pay out at 6 hours for me. But once I get officially put in the system as full-time will be 8 hours. So 60, 80. For this flex time, like sick time stuff, we get, that is a day off. Some of them get deferred. So like Easter, we get Easter Sunday off, but because we're already closed on Sunday, that's just like a floating hours I can use whenever. Hi, Selena. We gooning always. Then we get 56 hours, so 7 days of this like sick time that we can take as whatever. Like when I called out because I was not feeling the fantasy the other day, like that came out of there. And then PTO, I get 3 hours every paycheck currently. And we get paid bi-weekly. So I suppose 3 times 26 is, what's that, 18 and 60, 78. So almost 10 days. And I carried over from last year. Last year I got like a bunch, but I only worked there very briefly and I was in training for most of it. So I couldn't take really any time off. So I carried over like 3 days from last year. So, whatever, if that answered your question, I get, like, not counting holidays, I get, like, 2 weeks off. Damn, and here I barely survived with, like, 22 days off plus holidays. Well, oh, Addie, make sure to memorize Soy Un Pasivo for your Mexico trip. DJ, I'm going with my family. How dare you? If I'm gonna, how dare you? How dare you? But who knows? Maybe I'll need things too. We're going to an all-inclusive, so I intend to be drunk as a skunk the entire trip. I may have to appoint, you know how I like to appoint, if I'm acting a fool on a particular evening, I like to appoint somebody to be, in charge of the Discord. Perhaps I'll have to do that. Maybe I'll have to hold auditions. Cause that's a lot. We're going Monday to Friday. So, you know, I may have to take a peek and decide who is going to be put in charge of things, but I'm excited. Like we're actually like, it's so fun. When I recently forced my entire family to get their passports cause I had mine and Chase had his, we had both just gotten them recently, but Kelly, Brady, and Dave don't have them. And I was like, I literally took one of my days off. It was so nice. I was like, oh, work from home really is my fantasy. It was so nice. I took my laptop, I went out on the couch, and I sat there, and I filled out all the paperwork on the laptop. And I was like, oh my god, this is so, like, I just loved that. Like, I'm on my laptop, I'm on the couch, like, doing this. I was like, oh, imagine, like, if I went to a coffee shop, I was like, and I was like, oh my god, I need a work from home job. But that's besides the point. Look, you get lost in a big resort, you're drunk, and whoops, you fall into a toss pack. Escándalo. But I was like, okay, once I was doing this, I was like, I need to leverage. I was like, I can't just have us all get our passports and then we don't go anywhere and we don't do anything. I was like, I need to leverage this into a trip. And I was like, if we have to go to Canada, not that there's anything wrong with Canada, it's just not that anytime I mentioned it to my family, like, why do we go to Canada? Like, what and I was like, I don't know. So Mexico was my like step up, but also I think I could do it. So DJ, why are you making me read this? In the words of, hold on. Here's my response to you. Me sing DJ's message. Messages. There's been many. Bottled water. Tap water. Montezuma's Revenge.
Oh, to see without my eyes.
That was a lot of build up for not that much joke. But I love reverence. I love going, oh, to see without my eyes. Let me close my eyes. Let me pretend I don't see that. Not the Call Me By Your Name. I love Call Me By Your Name. I thought this was a moment of clam before the vocal started. It's a mistake you only make once, Eddie. Listen, Lana, have you ever been to Mexico? I tried. We almost had a many hour layover in Atlanta. But then Kelly and Dave were like, we are willing to spend more on a ticket to fly direct and not have to stop in Atlanta. But we were going to have like a 4 or 5 hour layover in Atlanta on the way home. And I was like, oh my God. Oh my god, I'll have Lana meet me at the airport. Oh my god. We could be two queens coming together to maximize our joint sleigh. With enough tequila, you can go anywhere you want. That's my thing. Tequila's fine. I always think I like it more than I do, and then I have tequila, and I'm like, eh. But I'm going to have to train myself up to loving tequila. You know who does not drink tequila is Kelly, and she's like, the hell am I going to do? And I'm like, I don't know. You're the one who agreed to go to Mexico. Brady's 18 and the drinking age is 18 there. So we're like, I was like, is Brady going to act a damn fool? And Chase was like, I don't know about him, but I'm going to. And I said, you two are not allowed to make Kelly and Dave regret this, because then guess what? This is never going to happen again. And I was like, you cannot ruin this for me. I do not need those two acting damn fools. And suddenly, we're never going on this big trip again. Because I need Kelly and Dave to pay for my international trips. Thank you. An ad is starting in a moment. For those of you who are not on an ad, I'm going to sit here and look beautiful. For those of you who are on an ad, I'm sorry, but I'll see you on the other side. Kelly and David should bring a nanny. I am available. You know, so we're going to this specific resort because good family friends of ours have gone there every year for years. And I used to do semi-joke with them that, like, I was like, if you bring me on your trip, I will ensure that you do not have to lay one eye on your children this entire trip. And it was mostly kidding, but I'm not convinced he was entirely joking. I think to him that was a little bit of like a, I never did go on the trip. Okay, the ad has started. So now I'm going to pose and look beautiful. I need to come up with something I should do on the ad breaks. Maybe I'll have a tic-tac. Should I have a tic-tac? I'm going to have a tic-tac. Strawberry and cream. It's a big package. They're very good for any of you. Anyone. I don't know who is and is not on an ad right now. Sometimes even people who aren't subscribed don't get an ad. I don't know. I'm not in an ad. Not everybody always gets them. I feel like when I'm watching people, I always get them, but not everybody always gets them. You know what's cute? You know what's adorable? You know what's so precious? Hold on, this is cute. Y'all are gonna love this. So, our location at work now is fully staffed. We're very staffed. At least we're not quite fully staffed, but we're very staffed. So, coming up, there's this week that, a nearby location has, like, nobody there and does twice as many transactions as us. So where one of us every day is going to be sent there for that week. So I'm on the Wednesday, which happens to be Valentine's Day. So one, isn't that precious? It happens to be Valentine's Day. And you want to know something else? It's right up near Kelly's work. So Kelly and I are going to get lunch on Valentine's Day. Isn't that so precious? Isn't that the cutest? Right. Isn't that adorable? I know you love it. So, don't worry. There's not an earthquake. I hit the, oh no, Addison's going to have a rival gate at the other location. I mean, I don't even know. I don't know if there, I don't know anything about the people who work there. We asked our manager today, like, what? And he was like, I don't really know who works there. They just need people. So that's fun. I have to track my mileage. We're going to get mileage reimbursed. I'm like, oh my God, does this mean I'm a real employee now because I'm getting sent to other places? Like, it's not just me having to ask how to do stuff all day. The waitress, happy. Well, that's the sad thing is we won't be able to go to, like, a real sit-down restaurant because I only get 30 minutes for lunch. And I'm like, I could ask for a longer lunch, but that feels real bold to be like, hello, I know I'm only working one day at this location this week and I'm helping fill in, but like, can I take an hour for lunch? It'd be such like a bitch move. So I'm like, okay, Kelly, we'll have to go somewhere like, we'll have to go to like a fast casual place nearby. Because I'm like, we will not be able, and I'll have to eat quick because I'm such a slow eater. Every queen is not the face in a battle. Not the queen, no. There's many sounds like.
HMMTOM cheered. X100. It's midnight now, so happy birthday from me to me.
Oh my god, Tom, thank you for 100 bits. Everybody, you better wish Tom happy birthday. Oh, that's what you meant, Tom. I didn't get... Tom sent me a message earlier, and I was like, what the fuck are you talking about? Everybody wish Tom happy birthday. I heard you're feeling nothing's going right. Why don't you let me stop by? The clock is ticking, running out of time. Tom, so I would have sworn you just recently had your birthday. It feels so close. I want to imitate. I have that one of that bear dancing. I don't remember what it's called. My birthday's always big news. Oh, okay. Yeah, yes. Breaking news, it's Tom's birthday! Happy birthday, Tom. Tom, for your birthday present, maybe you'll be able to get into the cult. No, I'm not starting a cult. I don't know what you're talking about. Starting a cult. Oh my god, but now I've said it. Okay, I can unplug my headphones now. I detest having my headphones plugged in. Okay, let me boot up the game. You guys, I'm so excited for this. I'm so excited! Are you excited? Raise your hand if you're excited. My hand is raised. For my birthday present, you to react to Ireland's Eurovision entry. Oh my god, okay, we're gonna do that first. I did promise Tom I'd do it on the next stream, and then I probably forgot to do it. Okay. I'm ready.
Okay, up next, we're off to McCroom.
All I ever wanted. Oh, I love that song. Okay. What is happening?
Avada-kedavra, the thoughts in my head, the places I touch when lying in bed, the visions of you, the words that you said undo. My heartbeat buried in the ground, and to the strings I bind your bound, so when you sleep, you'll hear my sound. I know you're living a lie. I see the scars in your eyes.
sorry, I'm not getting my life for this. If this was the first time I was seeing this, I would give it a 3. I don't care for this at all. Like, I didn't enjoy the beginning bit. I don't like the slower bits. I'm afraid there's nothing for me here. I'm not loving this. It's giving. I usually root heavily for Ireland, except for last year. It's giving non-qualifier. I'm sorry. If this makes it, when Ireland has sent so many other good songs that they started watching that didn't make it, I'll be upset. I'm so sorry, Tom. I'm sorry to let you down on your birthday, but... Not... I'm so sorry. I wanted to love that so much. I did not care for that song at all. I'm so sorry. But no, I'm sorry. At this time, boo. I'm sorry. I really wanted to like that. Currently, of the entries I've heard, it goes Slovenia, Ireland. Y'all dragging Tom so hard for his birthday. You couldn't even... I tried to pretend, but if I had not been on screen, I think I could have got away with it. But it was hard to hide my reaction. I'm so sorry. And it can grow on me. Last year when I listened to it for the first time, I said I didn't like Cha Cha Cha, and now it's nominated for best song at the Addison. So like, no, I don't want to turn those on. I liked it. I could see that. That sounded so shady. The studio version is so cool with the vocal effects. I didn't like Cha-Cha-Cha last year. It definitely has time to grow on me. I don't know that it has as much room to do so, but... I'm willing to explore. To be fair, if Gate wins Norway, I don't care for that song either, so... It seems like it might be a rough year for me after Eurovision. Alright. Off we go to be sacrificed. Did you or did you not come for me, Lana? I always come for you. I just think there's a lot of other entries from Ireland that was way better than that didn't qualify. So... We kneel to be sacrificed. Before us stands the last of its kind. All others we have hunted down and put to the blade. With this final sacrifice, the prophecy will be impossible to fulfill. The heretic who lies bound below will be condemned to eternal captivity. And the old faith shall be preserved. Jedward again would be nice. I would like to see Jedward again. I could have done with the first bit if the second bit then went like real cunt, real good, like what my kind, but it didn't. It went from I didn't like the first style to then I also didn't like the second style. I didn't think it didn't work for me. I didn't really go anywhere. What if I just left? Oh. I was like, I'm just gonna walk away. Hello. The one who waits. Edging King. Come closer. Fear not, for though you are already dead. Oh, I died? Oh, I didn't know that. I still have need of you. These foolish bishops thought they could keep you from me in death, but instead they sent you straight to me. I will give you life again, but at a price. All I ask is for you to start a cult in my name. Do we have a deal? Absolutely. Absolutely. Wise choice. Take the red crown which I once wore. It's kind of loud, is it not? Did that save? I don't know if I hit the right button there. Yes, it did. Much better. Take the red crown which I once wore. With it, you shall command the loyalty of followers and strike fear into the hearts of our enemies. Return to the land of the living, start a cult in my name, and begin recruiting followers. Once you have done so, you will see me again. Now go. He looks kind of like a kitty. Isn't he precious? Isn't the little lamb adorable? I mean, just precious. Okay. Now you're about to see me flop at some combat. So I play with mouse and keyboard. And one thing, I've tried it a little bit just to get used to it. But one thing with that is you have to aim your hit. I also played basketball. Helios, you played? I didn't know that. I love that. Fear not. I am Ratel. I was once a chosen vessel like you, but those days are lost to the winds. I was sent to guide you. We are deep in the lands of the old faith and in grave danger. My instructions are to lead you to safety. Continue through the woods. Escape lies ahead. I will be close by. Okay. Okay. I'm like 95% sure that I set up the Twitch integration correctly. I had some trouble with it. But I'm fairly certain that I have set it up correctly. At his high school nickname, Chosen Vessel. How dare you? Oh shit. I don't think you can actually take real damage in this first bit. I don't see like a health bar, so. I stayed up till like 5 a.m. without eating for like 12 hours. Thank you, Helios, for contributing to the cult's totem. I don't know if that works yet. I don't know if we have to make it past like the first, but thank you. We have nearly reached safety, but look ahead. Another poor soul about to be sacrificed. Rescue them, they would have no choice but to join your new cult. Almighty bishops of the old faith. We ask you to accept the sacrifice of this wretched soul. Hey, who interrupts our ritual and trespasses on secret ground? We should change the price. Can you? Those are like automatic things. I don't know that I can. My very first... You can manually lower it. We'll see. I'm happy with it where it is for now. Why do you think I should lower it? You think it's too high? I could consider going to 250. We have reached safety. You have done well. The Red Crown will allow you to use those markings on the ground to transport yourself great distances. It will take you to a temple that has fallen to ruin. There, you will be able to begin your new cult. I will meet you there. All right, everybody, here we go. Should I lower it to, like, 250, maybe? I'll consider it. Okay, we'll play medium. This hallowed ground, which once was mine, is now yours. This crumbling ruin is to be the site of your new cult. We have much to do. We begin by indoctrinating this poor soul in the warm embrace of your cult. Fathers can gather resources for you. Okay. Alright, y'all know how this works, or if you don't. If you don't. Oh, okay, no, I did not do it correctly. Great. Why is it not working? Wonderful. Great. So it's not working. So it's not gonna work. Wonderful. How do I... Do I just have to name this one? Do I just have to... I may just have to make this one. Hold on. Okay. Sorry. I don't know what the issue is. We'll make Kelly... Kelly the Moose. Okay, so what the hell was that? Oh. 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 Yeah. I see. Okay. All right. Oh, that's me. There we go. Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. All right. Yep. Okay. Okay. Sorry. Kelly's the first one. You are convinced to be the second one. Sorry. By your hand, our cult will grow powerful, but your followers cannot live on prayer alone. They must eat. Y'all always eat. Gather the necessary resources and build a cooking fire. It will allow you to prepare meals for your followers. Okay, we need wood and stone. Well, Kelly's getting stone. So I'll start chopping. I even, like, the reason I got on early is to make sure that I was, like, queuing everything up correctly and it was all gonna work fine. And then I promptly immediately fucked that up. That's okay. You all can be in the next person. Okay. Where do I put my cooking fire? Like, right here? I feel like that's kind of a cute place to put it. Okay, did it myself. You need food. Collect berries. Okay. That's fine. It's just, now we have more of a lead up so more people can come in and be ready for this. Now we must build a shrine, but first we will need more followers and more gold. Both of which can be found when crusading through the lands of the old faith. Our mutual benefactor, the one who waits, has been trapped by the four bishops of the old faith. Each of them guards a chain that binds him to the realm beyond. We have conjured openings to their realms. It is your task to track them down and slay them so that he may be free. Now go. Okay. So this is now my first combat. Now you're gonna get to... For any of y'all... This is way back. For any of y'all who watched me play Oh god, what's that game? What's the game I'm thinking of that's kind of like how the battles work in this? What's that game? And you keep doing it over and over again. You know, you keep trying to escape over and over. One of you people knows this. I know that one of you knows this. Whoever gets it first can be good noodle of stream. How about that? That game where it's like a roguelike combat and you just keep doing it over and over again. Like you're trying to escape and your dad is something. Haiti, you're right. Hi, Leo. Leo and Lana, congratulations. You can be co-strongest twink. You can be co- What's the title I'm looking for here?